amazing love is so great. Come on, someone, give the Lord a mighty wave offering. God is great. God is good. That song is a reaffirmation of what Christ has done for us. You mind we just take that chorus again? Just take that chorus.
Amazing love.
Express that love you have for Jesus. That emotion. Make this song so personal. About you.
I honor
you. Come on, somebody say, in all I do.
In all I do.
Say it from the depth of your heart right now.
I honor
yes, 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 Jesus. In all I do.
In all I do.
Oh, I do.
I honor you.
In all I do.
In all I do. I honor you.
Come on, come on, come on. Go ahead and worship him. Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead and worship him. Go ahead and worship him in all I do. Everything I find myself doing. Lord, I give you praise. I give you praise. I give you praise. I give you praise. Come on, go ahead and praise the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Go ahead and give him all the glory. Go ahead and exalt his holy name. Lord, we give you all glory. In all we do, oh Lord, we will honor you. We will honor you, O Lord, with our life. We will honor you, O Lord, with our strength. We will honor you, O Lord, with our substance. We will honor you, O Lord, with all that you have given to us. Amazing Lord. Amazing Lord. Emmanuel, we give you all praise and glory. What a mighty God we serve. Somebody, if you know and you know that you are the victory, that the Lord has given you victory over every circumstance, lift up the voice and shout the beginning, amen. Hallelujah. The love of Jesus Christ is no doubt amazing love. Amen. Amen. No greater love than this, the Bible says. And for a man to lay down his life. Be seated. Praise God. Hallelujah. I welcome you, if you're watching online right now, to the Dunamis Palace Network. We believe in this ministry that no matter how punctured and broken your life is, it can be sutured by God. Praise God. We know one thing for sure, that the destiny that God has put in our hands definitely must be fulfilled. Am I talking to somebody? That amen doesn't look like you. If you know and you know that you are the redeemer of the Lord, let that amen come like thunder. Hallelujah. Thinking about the love of Jesus Christ and all that he has done and so many things that he is yet doing within and around us, I just can't but say thank you. Praise God. You know, something happened in heaven because of the kind of love that God showed to every one of us. Even before we were born, he has already known us by name. And that love of God, the Bible calls it the agape love, the unconditional love. It's not a love that comes only when it feels okay. It's a love that goes beyond the faults of men. No greater love than this. And the angels looked at the kind of love that God has shown to man. And they asked a question. So, what is man that thou art mindful of him? What is man? What is man that thou art mindful? And I want you to personalize that word and put it this way and say, what is Kevin that you, the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings, are mindful of him? Put your name in there. Say it. Come on, say it. Say it like you mean it. Are you afraid? Say, what is that thou art mindful? Who am I that you don't just allow things to happen to me just like that? You know, many times I try to make us understand that we are not ordinary people. I have my book that is going to be out by God's special grace before September, thereabouts. Praise God.
And the title of that book is Demystifying the Man Created by God. Man is a mystery, even to the angels, even to the heavenlies. Man is a type that has never been made before. Man is a type that has never been created before. Even the devil could not understand what God was trying to do with man. God looked at himself. He said, I cannot relate and fellowship and interact with the beings in heaven. So therefore, for me to interact and feel myself as God, let me make a product that will be a total replica of me. And in the book of Genesis, the Bible said, and God said, let us make man in our own image, not in the image of the angels, no. In our own image, not just that alone, he said, and also after our likeness. Look at that word. After our likeness. After our likeness. Meaning, that was where the love started from creation. Man was created for the purpose of God. God made man because he wants to fellowship with God. I pray the Lord open your eyes today. God made man because he wants to fellowship with gods. He is the bigger God, and we are the gods. And the Bible said, know we not that ye are gods. The Bible went on to say that he has made his angels ministering spirits, messengers. And his ministers, he has made the flame of fire. Remember the scriptures? The Bible said something that God is a consuming fire. And if God is a consuming fire, if a consuming fire wants to give birth to something, it must give birth to a consuming what? Fire. That's why the Bible said, because you do not know who you are, so you will die like men. For ye are gods, the children of the Most High. But because you do not have understanding of who you are, that's why sickness and diseases will make you die like a mere man. If it's the wish of God that man should have some kind of terminal diseases or die of heart attack and things like that, God would have created those things inside of man. By talking to somebody? But because those things are not originally in the plans of God. And the Lord is saying to us this morning, until you are able to have the understanding that you are the gods of this earth, you may die like a mere. One of the things that you will understand about God, one of the characteristics of God, is having dominion over everything. And also in the book of Genesis, God told man, he said, have dominion over everything I have created. So in your atmosphere and in your environment or in your place of work, if you are not dominating, you will be dominated. Everything wants to dominate something. Spiritually, if you refuse to dominate your spiritual atmosphere, powers will dominate you. Physically too. Every nation of the world wants to dominate the other nation and to flex their muscles to let them know that they are superpower. The reason why America is not because of their dollar. America is America because of the kind of super equipment they have. That's why Brother Paul talked to us that we must allow our minds to be renewed. Renew your mind. You are not that old man. You are not that old woman in the past. Something has happened in your life. And because Satan knew very well that there is something about man, he went after man and caused man to sin. And when man sinned, the Bible said that man lost his place. But our God is a miracle working God. Satan thought that he has defeated God. But is it possible? Can the clay tell the potter how he must be made? Can the clay instruct the potter? God taught Satan a lesson that he is God and he knows all the shortcuts. And he can keep the eyes of Satan open, watching, yet his eyes is not yet open. And the eyes of the devil was open. He was watching. Jesus came, the place of the second Adam. And Satan kept on monitoring Christ. He knew there was something about Christ. But he never knew the mission of Christ. That was why the Bible said that, and in the book of Luke, chapter 4, that the Spirit of the Lord led Jesus up to the mountain for the purpose of fasting and praying. And in the place of the fasting, Satan met him there. Because when Jesus was fasting, he was praying. And I believe those prayers was hitting the kingdom of darkness. And they said, "Who is this person?" And they went up there. And when Satan saw him, he said, "Who is this guy?" And funny enough, the question came this way. If you are the Son of God. Satan knew that God would do something, but he never knew how God would do it. I pray this day that God will put confusion in the hearts of your enemies. They know that God will bless you, but they will not know the route how the blessing will come. That is the mystery. And it takes only those in the kingdom to demystify the mysteries of God. It's a code. You can't unlock it. It's not by going to theology school. No. You can't unlock the codes of God. You can't decode things from heaven via theology. For those that are of the spirit, they mind the things of the spirit. Those of the flesh, they mind the things of the flesh. And when Satan looked and saw Jesus, he said, "There is something about this one. Is it the one that is forthcoming? Let's test him." And the devil said unto him in Luke 4:1-44, and the devil said unto him, "If thou be the Son of God," if, meaning, I don't know if you are the one. My God. If thou be the Son of God, command this Son, because he knows that the Son of God is God and that God has the ability to turn stones into bread. So he wanted a proof. Somebody say proof. If that be the Son of God, command this stone that it be made bread. Next verse. And Jesus answered him, saying, it is written, not I am saying to you. Jesus placed himself in the word of God. See, it is written that man, he didn't say that God, that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of what? Of who? Of who? Did he confirm to Satan, he said, I am the Son of God? It's not everything you open your mouth to tell people. Not everything God discusses with you in the inner room that you come out in the open to say. Some things are best to be kept until they are ripe enough to come out. If you are indeed the Son of God, you know, if it were to be some of us, because we know we have the power, you are asking, so are you asking me if I can turn, bring the stone? Where is the stone? Bring it. And the next thing, the same stone turned to bread. The stone will turn into bread. But the mission has been defeated. Because the mystery of Jesus was not meant to be revealed. That was why when he healed some persons, he told them, he said, don't tell anybody. Jesus was not after the glory. He was after the restoration. His mind was not to get to the place of fame. Can I talk to somebody? If you indeed want to get to the place of glory and glorification, you must take your mind off fame. Take it off. Because when you place your mind in the place that you want to be famous, it is a major distraction to those that are going somewhere. And Jesus told him, say, no, you can't live by bread alone. Satan, I have not come to eat food made by the hands of man, but I've come to eat food made by the hands of God. That's why our Bible study will call it word feast. You're feasting on the word of God. Am I communicating with somebody? Let's see what verse 5 says. Verse 5. And the devil taking him up into where? A high mountain, showed unto him all the what? The kingdoms of the world in a what? A moment. Somebody say, a moment. You see, that tells you that in the realm of the spirit, time does not exist. Jesus saw everything that he created from the beginning. And look at senior thief Satan saying to him that I will give what you have to you. You know, that's what the devil does to some of us. He brings originally what you have and try to buy you into it, that you should sell your soul so he will give you what originally belongs to you. The devil is a fraudster, the chief of them all. The Bible called him the father of all liars. How can you go to submit your head to something you are bigger than? Does that make sense? As a believer, as a child of God, and you are passing through your moment, everybody, we always have a moment. And someone tells you and say, listen, I know of a place I will take you to. Let me introduce you to this Obia woman. And you call the name of Jesus. The Obia woman does not call the name of Jesus. You know that you are more powerful than the Obia woman. But because you are so desperate, you go and submit your head to a lower power. What an insult to salvation. Don't allow the devil to trick you. All what he was doing was to trick Jesus to unveil himself. And when he told Jesus, look at all the kingdom, look at the riches of this world. You know, what he tried to introduce to Christ was the God of Mammon. The God of material things. He tried to introduce those to Jesus. How can Jesus, that owns all things, be attracted by mansion? What is mansion? The other day, Jesus said, in my Father's house, there are many. So Satan took a photo of that mansion. Took a photo of that mansion and was showing it to Jesus. He said, see, this mansion is mine. Liars. And what did Jesus say to him? Verse number six. And the devil said unto him, all this power will I give thee, and the glory of them. Look at that. For that is delivered unto me. You know why? Because Adam failed. So he took all this from Adam, the glory. You know, man was made in the express image, which means the glory of God was placed on man. So when man fell, Satan took what? Look at that. He said, verse 6, he said, and the devil said unto him, who? Jesus, all this power, the power of man was taken. All this power will I give thee. Which means I am willing to bargain. If you can tell me who you are, I will give it to you. But he's a liar. In part B of that scripture, he said, and the glory of them. So which means there is a power that carries glory. God. There is a power that carries glory. Not all powers carry glory. You know why not all powers carry glory? Because there are people that they have acquired some level of power, but not from God. So the power has no glory. Remember, God said, my glory I will share with no man. Satan has no glory. So the devil decided to tell Jesus, I said, listen, I've taken something from the first man that came. God created him, and I defeated the first man. Jesus was listening. He said to him, he said, listen, I have the glory of them all. Who are they? Humanity. The glory of humanity was taken from man. After the fall of Adam, man was just trying to survive. The glory was taken. So Satan said, I've got the glory of them all. For that is delivered unto me. They gave it to me. Do not surrender your place to the devil. And to whomsoever, look at Satan bragging. He said, to whomsoever I will give it. Verse 7. Let's see something. Verse 7. Now, he now made his demand. If thou therefore would worship me, God of Mammon, all shall be thine. If thou would worship me. You know, there are people in the church claiming to be worshiping God, but their God is in their bank accounts. Their God is in that little file as their certificates. God of Mammon. And every day they bow to those images. Some of us accuse the Catholic Church that they are worshiping image, but some of us have our big images in our cupboard, right there in our houses. Do you know who I am? Some carry their image upon themselves. Do you know that I am the executive director and your hands are big this way? Can I talk to you? You are nothing but 6 feet above sea level. You are nothing but a dust. And from whence you have come, you will go. Boast not of thyself. If you must boast, boast of the Lord God Almighty and that he has done upon your life. Do not boast of yourself, for you are nothing without God. The Bible says, he that thinketh that he standeth should take heed, lest he fall. People have acquired so much position and they are crazy over these things. You know what? The God of Mammon will drive you crazy. The God of Mammon is the God of that makes you not to be satisfied with what you have. Anything you see your neighbors have, you want to have it. Any degree that your friend has gotten, you want to kill yourself. Because to you, every other thing you have acquired is nothing until you acquire this thing. The longing for things that are not yours. Having the appetite of not being satisfied with what you have. I am okay, and I give God all the glory. If I don't have a car, I have my legged Benz. You may be driving your Mercedes Benz, but I have my legged Benz. Your Mercedes can take you to that journey in less than 30 minutes. But I know, therefore, it's not about who starts the race first or who arrives first. Am I communicating? It's about how well you arrive. I'm not in any conflict or in a hurry with anybody. No competition, no. The Bible said that those that compare themselves with themselves are not wise. Everything the Lord has given to you today, be content with it. Do you know that discontent people, they breed jealousy because they are not contented? I've said it and I'm saying it tomorrow. Anything that God did not give me should not come to me. Anything that God by himself did not assign to me should not come. Because those things will only destroy me and not make me. The Bible says every good and perfect gift, they come from the Lord. So which means there are bad and wicked gifts. Not every gift is a gift. There are some gifts people give it to you, they mortgage your destiny. You are gone. Just take it, you are finished. Satan wanted to do Jesus the same thing. Just bow down and worship me. I'll give it to you. There are some believers today, when you talk about some high occultic groups like the Illuminati and the rest of them, they will tell you, oh, God forbid. Oh, my God. Illuminati what? But call them secretly and tell them, you have a mansion in Nevada. You have a private jet ready for you. You have $10 million. All you need to do, just bow to this image, and that is all. You have them all. I tell you, 75% of those that are quick to point fingers at people, we grab that offer. I have come to understand something about this life. Those that point fingers are guilty of the same thing. I tell you, go make your findings. Anybody that is always pointing finger at people, accusing them, is guilty of the same. And those that are quick to ask you to say sorry to them, never apologize to anybody. See, I'm telling you reality. And just check. Those around you that are quick to ask you to apologize to them, when it's time for them to apologize, they don't apologize. So this life, if you got to make it, you got to understand that you have to stay put with the word. Put back that scripture up. You got to stay put to the word. If thou therefore with worship, how can I worship the devil? To use him for what? I mean, the guy is not even handsome. People have tried to depict him through drawing and stuff like that. All the things I've seen is not admirable. And I should not make him my role model. Let me tell you, Satan has nothing. He only preys on the ignorance of people. If Jesus was ignorant of who he is, he would have fallen. Give me verse 8. Verse 8 of Luke 4. And Jesus answered, always have something to say to the devil when he comes knocking. Because the devil always come knocking. I tell you, for that you can't stop him. He has the license to be knocking on doors. That's why the Bible says for the enemy, the devil, he moves around like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may what? Devour. So which means it's not everybody that is devourable. Are you aware that the devil is a toothless bulldog? All he does is to put fears inside of you and threaten you. And immediately you allow fear to step inside of you, you've lost the battle. And Jesus answered and said unto him, get thee, some believers need to learn this word. Let it be part of you. When somebody come up against you with a false accusation, you look at them and say, listen, in the name of Jesus, you devil, get thee behind me. You have to be bold. Let me tell you, boldness is one of the equipment you need to put the devil down. Be bold. Your father cannot be a lion and you are acting like a goat. Lion will always give birth to a lion. The Bible says, for Jesus is the lion of the tribe of Judah. So how come Jesus gave birth to you and you are acting like a goat? A snake will always give birth to something that is long. A lion will always give birth to something that roars. A goat will always give birth to a goat. A group of lions led by a goat will lose their battle. But a group of goats led by a lion will win their battle. Who is leading you? Who are you following? A goat or a lion? Connect yourself with men that don't cry in the realm of the spirit. Connect yourself with men that embrace challenges in the realm of the spirit. Jesus embraced his challenge in Luke chapter 4. He embraced the challenge. He never ran from that mountain. I start running to Ananias. I said, hey, excuse me, Ananias. Did you hear what I was hearing at the top of the mountain? Demons are talking to me. They are pursuing me. Satan is up there. I'm not going to go. Am I communicating with somebody? Jesus said, get thee behind me, Satan. You remember there was a time when Jesus was talking to his disciples and he was talking to them, saying to them and explaining to them how his death is going to be. The Bible said that Peter took Jesus by the hand and went by the corner and started rebuking Christ and say, how dare you say you will die? Ah, Jesus, I pray for you, my senior pastor, Jesus. You will not die in the name of the Father. You will live. And Jesus said to him, Satan! He called him Satan. Many times the devil will always enter inside of people that are close to you. How many of you have seen the devil before? Nobody has seen the devil. But he walketh in men. They will always want to rebuke you when you are at the place doing the right thing. They will always want to put you down and let you think that you're getting it wrong. But I thank God for God. The Bible says those that do know their God, they shall do exploits. So you must know your God, the God you serve. When you don't know God is when any little wind that blows will carry you. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord, they shall flourish in the court of the Most High God. Be planted. The wind will always come. The challenges will always come. Be rooted. The Bible says, no weapon that is fashioned against you. Do you know the word fashion is produced? You know, it is a word that is used. They fashioned it, they produced it in a certain way. You know, it could be a rumor. They fashioned the rumor, they arranged it, packaged it, padded it very well. You know, look at the finishing. They finished it very well. Make sure that it's shining. But Jesus said, the Lord said, no weapon fashioned against you shall ever prosper. And not just that alone. He said, and every tongue that is risen against you, he said, you shall condemn. Not God will condemn. You will condemn. So as the tongue are wagging and lifting up, you are lifting up your voice and say, Father, I condemn the tongues in the name of Jesus. And I plead the blood of Jesus against every tongue that is wagging against me. You set yourself high. Am I communicating? God has placed you on a standard. Don't go down to the gutter with the devil. The Bible called him the deceiver. That he didn't start now. He started from the beginning. You remember? In heaven, he deceived a large amount of angels. Don't take the devil lightly. He is serious, so you better be serious too. And when Jesus had rebuked Peter and cast out the devil inside of Peter, he said to him, Simon, the devil has sought to sift you like wheat. Many believers are being sifted as wheat. How can you allow yourself to get so down to be sifted like wheat? And Jesus said to him, for I have prayed for you. Where you are delivered, make sure to deliver and pray for your brothers. Let me announce to you today, child of God, that the devil is on a mission. And God also is on a mission. Jesus came and he was on a mission. The devil was seated and watching everything that is coming from heaven. Which one is this one? He will go and investigate. Which one is this one? He'll go and investigate. That's how some people are with you. They don't rest. They are always on your Facebook, monitoring you. I call them monitoring spirits. Anywhere you go, they want to know what you said. You know why? You're a superstar. You don't answer irrelevant things. You break your head over relevant things. So when they break their head about you, you are very relevant. The devil will not fight a person that is a non-entity. He will fight someone that matters in the kingdom. So don't be worried when a greater battle comes against you. You know why? Because you are great in the realm of the spirit. And Jesus answered and said unto him, get thee behind me, Satan, for it is what? Written. Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God. Now, that the word thy God is the Lord your God. So, Satan still recognizes God as his God. Catch up. God created him too. I hope you're aware. Uh-huh. So Jesus reminded him, you remember that God is your God. Oh, okay. Stop looking at me. Like, the Bible said something. It said, for Jesus is the head of principalities and powers, including Satan. He's the head of them all. So he reminded him, young boy, you clay, have you forgotten that the potter is in control of you? And Jesus told Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. Did Jesus say he is the one here? Who Satan was looking for? The Savior, the Messiah, right? He was in search of the Messiah. But yet the Messiah is talking with him, yet he's still blind. I pray for somebody today. As the enemies keep hunting you up and down, the more they pursue you, the more they go blind. In the name of Jesus. Jesus never invited the devil to his party. Devil found his way there. Let them come. Am I communicating? Don't be afraid. The Bible says surely they must gather. So for the fact they have gathered, don't be worried. But the end of their gathering is what matters. He says surely they must gather, but any gathering that is not permitted by Elohim, they shall be scattered. You shall worship the Lord your God, him alone. Verse 9. Let's see what next. Verse 9. And he brought him. Satan does not give up. That's why sometimes I see believers, any little thing, pastor, you see, I'm so tired. Sometime last year, by the time we're getting into that was 2019. We're wrapping up the year. A man that is a pastor told me, he said, so we'll close the church. And I said to him, young man, church does not close. And the church does not go on vacation. How can you close the church? Does the devil take vacation? And when he said that, I knew where he's coming from. In this ministry, we don't have paper pastors. Pastors based on recommendation letters. No. We have proof. Men with proof. Men that when they say God has spoken, God has spoken. Am I communicating with somebody? When they hold up the word of God, they hold it with their faith, not being afraid, not wavering. The Bible says, he that wavereth is like the wave of the sea that is tossed up and down. He said, let not that man think that he can receive anything from the Lord. No wonder many pastors are struggling for many years, no results. It's because they don't hold that agreement with faith. There is an agreement in the scripture, and the word of God is where we stand. It is the agreement. And when we lift it up, the Bible says God was speaking. He said, put me to remembrance of those things I have spoken. When you carry the word of God and put it back to God, he said, my word that I have spoken shall not return back to me void, but it shall accomplish everything. Am I talking to somebody? So, he took Jesus and brought him to Jerusalem and set him on a pinnacle of the temple, at the top of the temple, and said unto him, if he's still guessing, may your enemy guess all through their life. You don't understand? May your enemy start going to the school called guessology. They will keep guessing. We know. But we have no proof. But we know. They are guessing. They see things happening, but because they are of the flesh, they cannot understand the things of the spirit. So they keep guessing. How is it running it? How is it doing it in this pandemic? Come on! If you need to know how far, come and meet us. Sit down in our Bible study, you will learn. Or come and submit yourself so you will be taught how to follow and listen to God. No pandemic can stop any man that the Lord is with him. There has been pandemic and drought in the Old Testament. The Bible says Isaac wanted to run away. God said to him, no, don't follow everybody that is running out of the city. Just remain in this same place. The same thing you have planned to do in this year, do it. And the Lord said to him, plant. He planted. And the Lord said to him, you will reap in hundredfold. And the Bible said it came to pass that Isaac reaped in hundredfold according to the word of the Lord. In a place where there is drought, no food, people are running. Let me tell you, you need not to run, for your Father owns the land. The Bible says he is the God of the heavens and the God of the earth. Am I communicating? He is not a geographical God. Mm-mm. God is not existing in Toronto alone, and in Scarborough is not existing. No. God is universal. He is the omnipotent and omniscience God. Am I talking to somebody? God is God. No matter how you look at it, no matter how you believe it, God is God. And when he took Jesus up there, he said, if thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down from hence. Look at that. He wasn't stopping there alone, because he saw that Jesus comes to him with the scriptures. So the devil went back to the scripture. Let me tell you, Satan knows the Bible back and front. I was praying for a girl some time ago. She was oppressed by demons. And while I was praying, the demon kept on speaking and challenging me. And I quoted the scripture. The demon asked me and said, where is it written? And I quoted another scripture. The demon quoted another scripture too. I said, okay. It is scripture quoting. Let's start quoting. When you have come to that level that demons ask you, please, that scripture you quote, where is it written? And they will tell you, didn't you read that Jesus said it is written? So the scripture you quote, where was it written? And when you don't know where it's written, you start scratching your head. Satan, in fact, shut up your mouth. Just come out. Ah, Lord of mercy. Satan went in for the scriptures. Now, in verse 10, this is what he said. Go ahead, verse 10. For it is what? So he was hearing Jesus all this while from verse 2, speaking. It is written. It is written. So Satan took, see, he's a photocopy agent. Imposter, copyright. In fact, we sue him in the name of Jesus. The man is a copywriter. He copied the statements of Jesus and used the words of Christ against Christ. For it is written, he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee. So Jesus, or whoever you think you are, don't be bothered. Just fall. Jump the pinnacle. When you jump from there, he has already told you that he will give his angel charge over you. So why are you worried? Verse 11. Verse number 11. And in their hands, he kept on, in their hands, they shall bear thee up. He explained in details. They shall bear thee up. Lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone. It is true. It was written. Am I communicating? It's the word of God. But would you want to be tempted because Satan is trying to prove you and fall into that temptation? Jesus stood his ground. And I love the wisdom of Christ. Verse 12. And Jesus answered, said unto him, it is said. Now Jesus turned the written, oh God of mercy. Oh, la dabaro shatagabaha. It's Satan. It is said. This time it was not written. But this time it is said. Which means it has been said and you knew about it. Don't pretend. Ah, said unto him, it is said, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God. Satan was like, hold on. What did he just say? And by the order of the scripture, he knows that as a fallen archangel, he must obey the said command of the Lord thy God. So therefore, he was halted. Go ahead. Verse 13. And when the devil had ended, he had to end it. When he had ended all the temptation, he departed from him for a season. And because Jesus flowed in the supernatural and had wisdom from heaven, from God, and because he was man completely, 100%, and also God, he knew what it feels or what it takes to be a man. And he still had the nature of God in him. The nature of God did not stop the feelings of man in Christ. Am I communicating with somebody? Because if it stopped the feeling of man in Christ, the crucifixion of Jesus wouldn't have been painful. The strokes of Cain, the lashes on him, wouldn't have been painful. But Jesus, the Bible said, took the stripes upon him. And the Bible said, our sins was with him there on the cross. He took everything and nailed it on the cross and said, it is finished. So every pain that you are going through today is over because it is finished. And because of the Son of God, the purpose of Jesus Christ, the purpose of the coming of Christ is to redeem mankind back to the place of glory. The glory that was taken, the glory that was seized, the glory that was taken deceptively from man by the devil. And in verse number 14, after the devil had departed and Jesus returned in what? You remember the power Satan said he had? And Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee. And there went out what? through all the region around about. Let me announce to somebody today, because you have waited on God on that mountain, the Lord will make you famous. In the name of Jesus. Jesus waited patiently. Forced the hand of the devil back to where it's coming from. The Bible said in the book of John 10, verse 10, it said, the thief cometh not. I pray for you today, any thief around you coming to steal your joy, your integrity, and all that the Lord has given to you all these years, may their hands be broken. In the name of Jesus, I command that they return everything they've stolen from you. Amen. If that amen is stronger, may it come to you in Jesus' name. Amen. He said, the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill. When they steal your joy, when they steal your peace, the next thing is that they want to assassinate you and to destroy. Jesus said, but I am come that they might have life and they might have it more abundantly. Rise up to your feet. That I have come that they might have life and they might have it even more abundantly. Open your mouth and begin to glorify the name of the Lord for the word that you have heard. Legobo Shabra Dagade, Prato Siti Kopahadush, Siti Brahanda Rabo Shatagabaha, E Perus Katia, Roskoparosh, E Deredo Shatabradosha, E Bradegede Brodosh. Lord, I receive this life even more abundantly. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you, O Lord, for the life of Christ in me. For Christ in me is the hope of glory. In the name of Jesus, I glorify your son Jesus in my life. In the name of Jesus, somebody open your mouth and pray that prayer like you mean it right now, even on air. In the name of Jesus, the purpose of Christ. For this reason was the Son of Man made manifest, that he would destroy all the works of the devil. In the name of Jesus, the works of the devil in your life and in your family are all destroyed today. In the name of Jesus, somebody jam those hands together to the Lord. Give him praise, give him praise, give him praise, give him praise. He's worthy, he's worthy, he's worthy, he's worthy, he's worthy, he's worthy. We give you all the glory. Say thank you, everlasting God, for the life that you have given to us. May your name alone, may your name alone, may your name alone be glorified. Thank you for the restoration of the authority that you have given to us. Thank you, everlasting Father, for making us who we are today. Are the joy of my life. You are the hope that I cling to. You mean more than this world to me. I won't trade for silver nor gold. I won't trade you for riches untold. You are my everything. You are the joy of my life. You are the hope that I cling to. More than this world.
I won't trade you for silver nor gold. I won't trade you for riches untold. Oh, oh, oh. You are my everything. Father, you are our everything. You are our Lord and Savior. For our sake, O Lord, you died and resurrected. And by that singular act, our sins are cleansed. What a mighty God we serve. I want to invite everyone right now. You don't have Christ in your life. You want to invite Jesus into your life. Just say these prayers with me. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. I acknowledge my sins. And I pray, Lord, that you have mercy on me. Forgive me, O Lord, of all my sins. Cleanse me, O Lord, from all unrighteousness. Lord, I believe that you are the Son of God. And I believe that you came to die for my sins. Thank you, Lord, because I believe I am forgiven. Thank you, Lord, that I believe that you've raised me from the dead. You've raised my feet, O Lord, from the miry clay. And you've set me upon the rock. Thank you, Jesus, for the salvation. I confess you today as my personal Lord and Savior. In Jesus' mighty name.